The first thing I did was mark the location of the bridge. Guadagnini's F-holes are fascinating. On the one hand, they follow a clear and simple geometric logic. On the other hand, they end up in the wrong place relative to where the bridge needs to be. He stuck with this for a bunch of instruments, but then eventually went back to putting his F-holes in the quote-unquote right place. For this instrument, I'm sticking with the strict geometric ratio layout Guadagnini used, and accepting that the notches of the F-holes will be off from their usual placement. I then marked where the corners fall and found the point halfway between them. This is where the upper eyes of the F-hole will go. The distance in from the center to the eyes of the F-hole is also a whole number ratio. I did the geometry ahead of time on paper, which is how I'm setting my dividers. The final shape of the eyes won't be exactly circular, another Guadagnini quirk, but they will start out that way. This is the template for the F-hole itself. It too can be drawn by geometric construction, but it's a lot easier to transfer it to the violin via template. I'm pinning it into place, which is fine, of course, because the pinpricks are all on the inside of the F-hole, so they'll be carved away later. The last step is to trace the template, and then do the same thing on the other side, for which I'll use the same template, but just flipped. That's it. Hit like and subscribe to make sure you catch the next steps.